Hi everyone, I'm Robbie Herring here for Artist Live today, and I'm excited to be here, and we are going to make this project. And when I made it, I wasn't really thinking clearly that it's a pretty big project, because this is 8x16. So it makes it a little tough to fit in the picture, so we'll zoom in later and make sure that y'all can see things, and Karen will message me if there's something that I'm missing that y'all want me to zoom in on. But it started with just a regular canvas that is made of burlap, and you can see I pulled it apart, which is something I usually do. I've used inexpensive things from the dollar store and from Hobby Lobby, any craft store, just inexpensive clay pots, and of course some of my favorite Prima products, which mostly flowers. And so let's get started. I'm going to move this aside and try to put it where I can see it. I made this pretty early, so I want to make sure I can see it to make sure I don't forget anything. So I told you I started with the canvas, and it's just a plain burlap canvas that I picked up. Like I said, 16 by 20. And then I've already done it ahead because, like I said, there's a lot of ground to cover. These are stapled, and I use just a little screwdriver, and if I need to, some little wire working project or jewelry making tools to pull them out. But I've done that ahead because, y'all, if you've seen me in the past, there's one time I like bled because I cut myself. So when you do it, make sure you keep your hands out of the way. But so all the staples has been removed, and let me pull it up so you can see where these staples were. And I like to do this because I like to get a shadow box effect, and it gives me, it is 8x16, and it gives me a place to put things inside with the shadow box feel, but yet still be something a little different than your average shadow box. And you can see that this is kind of glued down, and all of them are. So what I did was, is I opened it up, and so now I have my wood piece. Let's get that, it's all stuck. They pre-gesso these as a rule, so you can see I have my little frame here. And so what I did was, to start, is I wanted to color it because I didn't want it to be the solid wood. Super simple, I used Prima Color Bloom, and this is leather, or worn leather. And I sprayed it a bit. And then I just moved it around a bit. You can add some water, and in fact, here's my water. So if it gets a little blotchy, but we're gonna keep adding layers and stuff to this. So don't worry if it's blotchy or anything like that, because all of this is gonna come together in the end, and it's not a perfect science. And you want to, because we're gonna glue this, so you wanna make sure, if you remember on the other one, I like to leave parts open and closed, so make sure you get the inside here. The outside doesn't matter so much, but make sure you give yourself a pretty good cover. And that was it. Now, in the past, I love to stencil on these. Sorry, I'm gonna clean this up a bit because I'm gonna get a little bit of this off. I love to stencil on these, and in the past I would try to put my stencil in, and just totally by accident I realized that I don't have to do that anymore. So before gluing this down, we're going to stencil. And I love this because by misting first, I have my outline, so I know where my stencils are going to go and where I would like to do it. And this is a chicken wire stencil. It's from Prima. You'll see a lot of Prima in this project. And then I used the rust paste. And part of the reason I chose the chicken wire, you can use anything, but I thought, well, I'm doing a rusty garden spade. How about doing a rusty, something that would normally rust itself? And that's why I decided, whoops, to choose this one. So if you haven't used these, whoops, they're terrific. They're a lot of fun to use. They come in, there's three colors, a dark brown, which has a name, brown rust, gold rust, and red rust. So, all I did was I wanted it to be rusty and I want to choose where I'm going to do it. Like I said, I have my line here and I can kind of still see it here. And I started with the brown. And just like you would stencil with modeling paste or anything like that, that's what you're going to do with this. And you can hear it's got kind of a gritty texture. Whoops. Of course, I'm going to mess it up on the first thing, right? But like I said, this is a rough looking thing. It's supposed to be rusty and supposed to be distressed. And so don't even worry. I'm not even going to look till I pick it up. But also, I did the brown, but I wanted to make sure that I put a little bit of this other color, the other rust in it, to make it look rusty. And so you can see I'm just dipping this in. There's no real rhyme or reason. Didn't even mess it up too bad. How about that? Some days things go well, even when you make a mistake. All right, I've got some mess over here. Okay, and so you're just gonna randomly, or not randomly, however you want to do it, put some of this in the corners, and we're gonna put some on the wood. I should have got out another package of this because this one's running a little low. Okay. And we're just going to give some hints of barbed wire. I used to live out in the country and we used to garden and, I mean, not garden, chicken wire. And we had chickens. And so chicken wire was definitely a staple around our place. And so you can see I'm just building a bit of a background. Now, there's no need because we're going to have this covered. So there's no need to work here on the bottom. Just the top is going to show. And I'm going to move this aside somewhere and we'll do the wood so I don't mess things up. Now the wood, more of it's going to show, but again, it's going to be this side and the top that's going to show because our spade is going to go here and all of our embellishments are going to cover. So we're going to do some of the same thing here at the top on the wood. And here in a sec, I'll read the chat when I have to dry this a tiny bit. And that way, if there's any questions, and like I said, otherwise, Karen can message me. It looks like I may have a message. Okay, making sure. All right, so just keep working a little bit of the color here and there. I'm gonna go ahead and go down here a little bit further. And again, add a little bit of the red rust color or orange, whatever you want to call it, and add a little bit of the yellow. And you can see this seeped under a tiny bit. I must have moved it, but don't worry about anything like that because, like I said, this is not a project that is meant to be a perfect science. All right, now I'm going to put some here. And you can see that I'm just dipping this in. When I use this stuff, I tend to get it all mixed up anyway, so I'm not really too concerned. If it really bothers you to have, you know, a little bit of brown or red or whatever in your other colors, you can clean between. I just chose to just go for it. Okay. So that is all you really need. You can put a little, and in fact, let's do a little bit down here in case it shows, and then we'll move on. I didn't do this so much on the other one, but let's just give it a little hint down here. You know how it is when you look back at your projects and go, oh, I wish I had a little bit there. So this time I get to. I didn't care enough to go back and redo it. So that'll give us a little hint there at the bottom. Okay, and that's all you're gonna need for your stencil. And I'm gonna just wipe this off to get it going. And we are going to, now we're going to layer it back. So, instead of having to tuck it up there, now it's all ready to go, it's set, and we can do that. But let's go ahead and start the gluing because I want this to be drying in the process. And you can do it two ways or three ways, any way you want. I like to take it and put a little bit on the back. There's almost all these have, in fact, this side's pretty too. They almost all have some kind of something that's higher that's going to attach. If I put glue down here, it's not going to attach. But this will get my base going. Certain things you can't do ahead. Okay. And just line it up. And then I like to put a little glue around the sides. I'm using Fabri-Tac. I like that it tends to grab a little bit quicker than most other glues, especially when I'm working live. You can use whatever you would prefer. And then I'm gonna see if it'll grab a bit. The other thing is too, that if it doesn't grab as quickly, it stays tacky a little bit. And so I'm gonna set this aside and let it dry while we work, but it'll still be tacky enough that I can push and make it grab a bit more if needed. So I'm gonna set that aside and let that start drying. And we are going to talk about the spade. So while we have all our rust paste out, I always wear everything. I start out with clean, nice hands, and it doesn't matter what I do. That's part of it for me. And so this I picked up at $1.50 at Michael's. It is a cheapy garden spade. You can pick them up at a dollar store, at a Walmart, pretty much anywhere this time of year. They just happen to have these that fit correctly. I didn't want to use this foam part, so I pulled that off. And I found that if I just got underneath there, I could just cut it right off. And so we end up with this. So now we've just got the wood, and we've got this lovely green, which we don't want. And I have seen a million ways of people using this rust paste. So I'm going to show you what I did. I took the brown to start and put some on here. And I kind of thought this was not a bad idea either because I wasn't wasting it by just putting it on here. And then I took a super old paintbrush. You can see this thing has been beat up, and I keep it for the very reason of just things that I need to do like this, or, you know, if I want to put something grody on it, it doesn't matter. Now, one thing I did do is make sure that you're putting this on the back places that might potentially show. So then I just moved it around. I wanted it to have some texture. I wanted it to be like it really had sat out in the garden and gotten rested. And you can see by when I'm moving it around, let's see if you can see, I'm kind of getting brush strokes, but I didn't want brush strokes, so I went back and got rid of them. The other thing I said, you could leave part of the green if you want to, because you've got green, you could add some more leaves. I've got a few showing. It's totally up to you. The other thing I did in that whole spirit of let's make sure the parts that might potentially show, I did the edges of the back. I avoided the bottom where I'm going to glue, and I avoided this where I'm going to use glue in the center. But that way, if you know you set it somewhere and somebody's standing beside it, you've definitely got the rust covered on that little back section. Not a lot, and I didn't add extra color back there. I just made it dark to where it was covered. And then same thing, I added in a bit of orange. And a bit of yellow here and there. Not a lot. I missed. That's a lot more than I want. But just enough to give it some hints of that extra rusty color. So, like I said, make sure you get all the different little spots. You can work and work and work, or you can just say, that looks pretty good. So there's that. And then, like I said, a lot of ground to cover. So, put that away. And let me put the lids on these, because we are done with them, I believe. Unless I forgot something, which would not be real surprising. All right. And let's wipe this off. Okay, next step. You can see this is not a neat one. Let me clean it up just a bit though, so we don't have it everywhere, because I am definitely one that's gonna do that. So I didn't want to waste a lot of time drying, so here's a dry one. You can see, I'm gonna move it up close where you can see. See, I've got some yellow and some orange, left the tip, left the middle, and it's covered. Next thing I did was, is I took some plain jute, because I didn't like the way this looked without anything on it. So I took some jute. This is a pretty good handful. And it takes, y'all will have more time. I'm gonna guesstimate it. How much when you're doing it not live, and I just got it in a knot, of course, when I'm trying to do it quicker. When you're not doing it live, you can take as much time as you want to figure out how much jute you want to a magic dry one. That's it. How much jute you actually need. This stuff is so inexpensive though, I don't even really care if I have a little waste. And so what I did was I halved it, and this is only just to make it easier. You can just glue it, but I wanted it to be fast and easy, so I stuck that through there. And then the other thing I did was I took some Fabri-Tac so it would glue down as I went. And I put a line. So, easy breezy to wrap. Now, this wrap, I want to go the opposite way of where I started. And you're going to have to hold it because it's to get it started, because it's not going to stay perfect. And then just wrap it. Hang on a sec. Let me get all entangled. And that way on the back, it is grabbing as you go. So see, now that I've started, I'm pretty good to go. And it's grabbing on that glue on the back side. So any glue that shows, you're good. I need to quit trying to look at the chat and wrap. I'll look at the chat when I'm doing something that doesn't require much. And I didn't care, you can see, I'm not being careful to make sure it's wrapped perfectly. This is supposed to be a little aged thing. Okay, so now I'm to the end, and I'm trying to remember how I did this. I told you there would be something I would forget. Let's just do one here at the end, and then let's go ahead and see if we can tie it this way. I think I glued it, so we're going to glue it, but I'm going to get us a little knot there to glue. There it comes. I love these new real thin tips they have on the Fabri-Tac, but sometimes it takes a little longer to get the glue out. And then I'm going to tie this in a bow, because you know me, if you know me, you know it. Everything pretty much requires a bow. And let's let that stick a little bit. And then other thing is to make it go with the other wood, I took a little bit of that same brown mist, that worn leather. Let's get a brush. I'm going to hold that a little longer while I do it. Like I said, if that comes unstuck, I'll stick it back. And added a little bit of that same color to the wood part portion of this. You could miss the whole thing if you wanted. I just chose to do it this way. And then I made sure that I got a little bit of that on the deal too. So let me pull this up close so y'all can see. Let's make sure we get the top, because I didn't. So that is it for the spade. And then let me set that aside. Next part was, you can see there's just a lot, nothing's hard. It's just a lot of little steps, but very doable. And I'll tell y'all too, the rust paste doesn't take that long to dry. It's just being live. So these are 2 3/4 inch little floral things. I got them for $2.99 at Hobby Lobby, but everybody has these little things, any craft store. And just the little clay pots, and I say I got them for $2.99, if it's me, so trust me, I used a coupon. So I got them for less than that, and then I went and raided my husband's toolbox and got me a little hammer. Yes, I did add rust paste, I see what you're saying, to the shovel. Okay, so then you want to be a little gentle. And the reason I'm breaking them is because they're going to set better in the project if they're not so round on the back. But, sorry, this is going to be loud. I'm sorry. And, of course, yeah, there it goes. So, you can see this one broke a little rough. I may glue that in and keep that crack. I like it. If there's a part that you don't, I'm going to keep that for sure. I actually really do like it. This will be the bottom one, so I'm going to leave some of this. But if you don't like it, pull a little bit off. You can break it down a little bit more. Messy, but remember, don't be perfect, because I don't care how hard you try, it's not going to be perfect. And then I want two larger pieces, so I use two of these pots. And let's see. And you see I'm kind of working around. I don't know if y'all can even hear me because it's so loud. And for now, I'm going to leave this. I ended up with a pretty good half, so one of these will work, I feel certain. So here's my pieces. I want to keep this one that's cracked. I love that. And that's kind of the cool part of this too, is that it doesn't, you're going to get something different every time. Nobody's is going to look identical. I like projects like this because you can use any colors you want. I chose blues and browns. Because of the basic background color, I mean, any color flowers you want, you can add. Let's see. I don't even have to touch it. I can see. So we're going to do a tiny bit of drying before we glue. I was hoping it wouldn't have to. And I'm going to do a tiny bit of holding this glue down too. And now we're, as soon as I get this dry enough to not smear it everywhere, we're going to move on to we're going to move on to how to build it. The other thing that I'm looking at, I chose not to stencil here on the insides and stuff. You can go as far or do as little as you want. I just didn't see any really, I felt like it had enough going on that we were good. And I'm going to hope that that's about dry enough. Okay. And I like to use, this is a foam board I take my photos on. I like to keep some of this around. That way when we're building, if you see me grabbing white, that's what I'm grabbing, is just pieces of that. So, first thing is we need to figure out how we're going to do it. Like I said, the pots are always different. Everything's about different, and you're going to want to find a way, and this one I'm actually going to bend a little bit because it doesn't set too nicely. So let's see if that's a little better. Yep, that was enough. You're going to want it to grab on. So this one is, I can look at it, and it's going to grab here and here and at the tip. And so I'm going to go ahead and put some glue on those and get that going. So it'll be grabbing and getting more stable for the embellishment process. And that is your base. So everything else is going to revolve around this. And I think I'm gonna add a little bit more glue right here on the edge. I'm looking at where it's touching and making sure I have enough glue to make it grab. Once this dries, it'll be permanent. I feel sure that I will accidentally move it at some point in this process because I'm not giving it an extra bit of drying time. And then you want to kind of figure out where these are going to fit. And do you want it overlapping? Do you want it right there together? And I'm going to glue this back in. This may not stick for me, but I'm sure going to try. And then let's see. This one, I think that works. And then I have one over here too. If y'all can hear my dog scratching to go out, I'm sorry. She's in there having a fit, but I'm alone today, so there's no one to help. I think that'll work. Okay, so we're going to glue, start here. And same thing, you just want to make sure you're putting glue in places that allow it to grab. Can always pick it up and add more. I didn't even look that closely at this one, frankly. Not sure how I, there, that works. And actually I can see that's not gonna work. Let's get a little more glue under here. So just keep playing with it. The other thing is too, if I were leaving it this way, and I actually want it tilted up a bit. If I were leaving it this way and not adding anything, I'd be being more careful. But because I'm gonna build flowers around it and adding more glue, because I'm gonna put flowers around it, it's really not necessary that I have as much glue because every layer of the project, I'm gonna be adding glue. Let's see how I like this. How about right there? I'm going to be adding glue with every layer, so I'm pretty golden that everything's going to stick at some point if I've got glue on everything. And you can see I'm kind of making sure they're up tilted a little bit, not totally flat. Still not liking that one so much, but I think it's going to be fine. All this glue that I'm getting everywhere is going to be covered with flowers. Okay, this one is going to stay a little more close in than the last one I did, but that's okay. And this I'm going to put a bit on the bottom because I'm going to tuck it in there. And I think that's going to be the best way to get it to stay. I'm having to watch the recording too, because if I look at that, I can kind of see where things are. Let's do it there. That I like that better. And let me put a tiny bit of glue there now that I figured it out. And see what I'm saying? It's kind of a puzzle to get this to fit. But once you do, you're good. And we'll let that dry. So that is the total base of our project. So now comes what I always think of as the fun part. And that is starting the process of embellishing. So, again, we're gonna build here. And I got at our dollar store, so it was a dollar, a bird. Again, I know they're at every hobby store, everywhere, Walmart, you know, pretty much anywhere you want. Just a little brown bird. And then I bought these at our Hobby Lobby, I bought these little nests. Couldn't think of what they're called there for a minute. And they were $2.99 for two. And what I did was, and this is going to be so messy, so y'all get ready. And I'm going to do it. I cut it in half. And I'm going to do it over here so I can swap it, keep it off of the center of the project. And I say I cut it in half. Cut it maybe in a little bit less. And you could use more than one bird because you have an extra. Even if you just buy one of these, you're going to have an extra piece. So I could put it here with another bird, and then I glued it to the top. I will say for my little dog, she's relentless. She hasn't stopped yet. All right. And then you just want to tuck this in here. I'm going to hold it a minute. See if it'll stick. But see what I mean about how we're everything is gluing to this, gluing to that, and how it's all going to end up sticking. I got that under there. Let's clip that off. So let's clip this one a tiny bit too. Get them out of the way. All right. So I don't like the way this one's doing. So let's go to this foam and cut off a little piece. And I'm going to tuck it up. And normally I just go with it, but I want y'all to know that it really, there's all kinds of ways to keep adding and getting it right. And I drop that in there. Let's put it there. There. So I've got a little something else, and this one's fixing to break down the center. We're live. Of course it broke down the center. It never does that when you're doing it yourself, right? But I kind of like the cracks. I especially like this one. I think it's cool. All right. I will probably pull that apart again. But let's put our little bird on here. Oh, this one happens to come with a clip. Let's pull it out. You can leave it. Most of these are just made of foam. At least every one I've ever bought. So I would assume that is the norm. Yeah. Let's get him some room to sit in there. And now we can do the fun flowers. Looking at, I'm doing pretty good on time considering all things. Okay, so next up, I'm going to work with the flowers and start building those in. I used 2 packs of flowers, and I'm pretty sure I used everything in both of these packs. And these are Prima that are from the French Riviera collection. But as always, you can use any flower you want. Let me clear some space for myself. Or whatever's in your stash. Blue is my favorite color, so I'm very drawn to it. So I tend to, and then these are, I don't know what these are from, but they're also Prima flowers, and they're kind of fabric. These are paper. These are more, have more of a fabric feel. And I'm just gonna dump them out here to make it easy. And then we're going to start gluing on. And I've already done one, and you can do the same thing. You can follow what I did, and I'm going to do that today. Or you can add, you know, however you want or change it up. But I'm going to follow pretty true to what I did on the last one in the interest of time. So I tend to like bottom-heavy projects. So I tend to have larger stuff at the bottom of my projects. The other thing pointing out about all that too is I don't like things that are truly centered. So I like that this is heavier on one side, it's tilted, it's not straight up the center. And that again is, I certainly do it the other way too, but it comes down to personal preference. But that was kind of the thought process behind here. And we are going to start putting the beautiful flowers that to me really, and I'm using the largest flower in that same vein on the bottom. But to me, the flowers and all the little details are what I loved about this type of project or any of the ones y'all do or that everyone does. I like these flowers and the details that come in. So, and use a couple of leaves. And again, I'm using Fabri-Tac. Just going to pull this out of the way if you need to, whatever you want to do. Like I said, it's not truly stuck, it's not truly dry. You've got some wiggle room with the Fabri-Tac. I loved these little berries, especially for this project, and you'll see how I added some more. I'm going to cut off these ends. You can use these ends to add in. I can't remember if I did or not, if you want to add a little bit of rounded wire. And then let's do some of these big ones and get this all glued in together. Getting some air in there. There we go. And in fact, let's just do this. Let's put some glue on a few of them while I've got it here. Because I know I'm looking at my project to see what I use. So we'll have a few. Okay, that'll cut down too. All right, so just keep building. And you can see I'm going back and pushing in to make sure everything grabs hold. And don't feel like you have to put all your flowers like upright. You can put some to the side and however you want to go about it. Oops, let's see if I can not do that. Now I'm going to wear the glue too. This one's going to tuck in here. You can see we're just giving the bird a really pretty base to sit around. What else do I got? Let's put one of these here. All right, and some of these little ones. And I love these too. Let's see, I think I did 3 and 3. And then I cut that off and I'm going to give it a little twist so they'll just all be easier to glue together. You can glue them individually, but you don't have to. I'm all for easy is better. And once this dries, it'll be easier for me to manipulate a little bit more. So I may come back and manipulate those. I may be fine with it. You never can tell. And then let me cut this one apart. Put a few of these up here. Kinda, let's scoot that up a tiny bit. I love this crack. It's the silly things that you end up liking in your projects. And let's see, let's tuck that in. And we've got this and the berries up in there. Uh-oh. Again, if you cut too close like I did, just give it a little wrap and you can tuck it in there. If y'all have questions, I see Karen's leaving. I am trying to watch the chat. And if Tiffany is still here, she has my number. She can text me too. So again, remember we can always go back and manipulate these further once it's a little drier. And this one, let's see. And actually, I'm going to add a little foam. I think I did, looking at it. A little bit of this foam. And what do we got? That one will work. And about that. And I use this little one. And I'll hold this up so y'all can see a little closer here in a bit. What do I want to use? Let's use this one. I can't really even tell because I put stuff on them. So some of them I'm not real sure. So like I said, none of these are ever going to be identical. Even though I'm copying, it's still not going to be identical. So never worry about that. And then, so that really covers this side and it's really pretty. But now to me, it was really lopsided. So I added over here, which tends to be the spot I go to. I think all of us have the way we like to see something lay out. And you're just tucking by different sizes, I like the different textures where we've got some paper, some more that feel a little more like fabric. So just keeping all the different textures and sizes going here. I don't know of a better way to say it than that. And actually, that blue one is disappearing, so I'm gonna stick some foam under it. And that's the thing too. This one tends to want to sink down. I think y'all can see it. And so I want the blue, because most of the project is brown, I don't want the blue to sink down and disappear. So putting a little bit of foam under it raises it up and lets it be center stage again. And then let's see, about right here. And here. Okay, I didn't use the whole thing. I don't think I'm going to use all the leaves. We'll see if I tuck something in later. But I thought I used all of it, but I didn't use quite all of it. And again, I'm tucking into this little, whoops, now I was, except I moved the whole thing. I'm tucking in up against the canvas. And same thing is happening that happened last time. I didn't like the way this was getting so straight and sitting up. So here's my little trick for when I don't like that. Let me get my, there it is. It's like I lost my jute. So I like to take a piece of jute, and those places where that's happening that I don't like, I will put a little slit with my seam ripper. Tends to be the easiest. And this is about, I'm really not going to be able to show y'all up close, but, and the reason being is because everything on this is going to shift because it's not dry. And then, but I'd say about half an inch. And then I like to stick this jute or ribbon, which frankly I usually use ribbon more than, and I didn't get that big enough. I like to stick something through it and give myself a place to tie it down. I'm just making a total mess. There we go. All right, and obviously I'm gonna have to replace some of this. And then I'm gonna let it just gather up tight, tight. See what I mean about the wiggle room with the glue? I still, and I don't know if we'll have time to show you, I'll go back and add glue to make all this hold the way I want it to, but I like to add some of these little details to give me some interest. I like things to hang outside, and that is what that accomplishes. So that's, to me, much prettier than having it sit just totally flat up against that. So, and like, see right here, I'm gonna need more glue. We'll stick some there, but I'm not giving any of this, in the interest of time, a lot of time to dry. So be sure to have a little bit of patience to give it some time to dry. Okay, same thing. So now I've done that. Same thing over here. I could do it, but here is a place that's just not very interesting without something. So let's add one there. And I'm getting this one, you might can see, since the glue hasn't totally set yet. So you can see here that I'm giving it this opening. There. I can't make it show really, but so you've got your opening there. And again, a bit of jute. Would y'all believe I was fixing to say, what'd I do with my jute again when it's literally by my hand? That one went much easier. See how I'm tying it and just getting it tight? And I'm just going to leave these long for now. They will definitely be trimmed at some point, I feel certain. And then I'm going to go ahead and start showing you all this. I've done some of these ahead in the interest of time, but once I start putting color on this, I want it to be more distressed. Again, I'm not liking these lines. So what I do is I take a seam ripper and I just, all along it, I rip. You can pull some of these pieces off and distress it. But all the way around the edges, pretty much every time I do this, I seam rip it. The other thing is these, I just messed up the whole thing. These corners that are super folded, if those are a perfect place to rip it and let it open up a bit more. Let's see if I can, trying to make sure y'all can see, which makes for some weird angles. So that gives me some more distressing. You can work this way. Main thing is too, is these things are sharp. So be careful, one, not to cut yourself, and two, not to poke yourself. So make sure your hands are out of the way. And I did go all the way around. And then I also put a bow up here. So we're gonna go ahead and put a bow up here. And see that one I cut way too much. It doesn't matter. I'm at the end of this. So the whole thing just came out of the package and I don't have any. Oh well, I'll do it this way. The edge stuff is burlap. It's a burlap canvas. So everything is burlap. And this one I am going to trim a bit because otherwise it's going to be hanging in our way. Okay. So, let me turn it back up so y'all can see it right side up again. Excuse me. All right, so we have a bow here. We have this bow up here. I cut this a little short. I'm not really liking that, but you can add a little bit more if you want to. So, I've got my bows. And then the other thing that I wanted to carry that through, and this is what I'm talking about building. So we're gonna add some more. So I'm getting my burlap ready because I know that's gonna happen. And then here's where the details come in. This is our base and it's fine, it's pretty. But to me, where it goes to what I like is now when all the extra little details start to happen. So we have our whole background. First thing is, and I'm gonna show you all the done one, is that how this is so simple, look how much prettier it is when we add some garden moss. And this is stuff that, again, is at any craft store. It's just moss. You can see I bought the big bag because I always need it. And I'm really not making it up. I have raided my arrangements at home sometimes when I'm in the middle of a project. So I bought the big one because I also want to go put it back in the things that I've stolen it out of. It is pitiful. So these are empty, so I am going to add a bit of foam into them. This one, of course, doesn't need anything, but these just to kind of hold everything steady and to give that moss something to sit on and attach to. And what I'm going to do, as you can see, I just did a couple little squares. And I'm gonna glue them together. They're not perfect. They weren't when I did the first one. And that gives me a place to let this foam. And I'm not even worrying about getting much glue or where the glue is. excuse me. Now I've got started, I may not be able to stop. So, this one I'm not even sure I'll need to. You want it to be hidden, and it will be. And you can always add more foam if something shows. Let's see, I think one, because that one's pretty narrow. If some of it shows, not more foam. You can always add more moss. And then I took some of this moss and started gluing it in. To all the little pots. And so this one has nothing in it, so you're gonna want it to be a little bit larger piece, and that one is not quite large enough. A lot of these things are messy in this project. But easy cleanup. And I can't see that, y'all. So I'm going by feel. I think it's attached, but I'm gonna add a little bit more. Just looking at the camera, I can see it's not quite sticking out like I'd like it to. So tuck a little more in there, and all this is going to attach and glue. This one here, I like this little piece here for down here. We need something here. Let's just put a little glue here. There's a little glue still left on here, so I think this one's gonna be easy to attach. So you just wanna tuck this in to what your vision of it is, and actually, there's still glue attached that's damp there, so I'm gonna tuck some into this little corner. I didn't have this little nifty thing here on the last one. But let's see, let's get a little bit larger. And actually, let's do this. This also, like here, I don't like this opening. So I'm gonna put some glue here, and I'm gonna attach moss in there. I tuck some up. I'm just gonna go ahead and glue in the sections. The other places that I thought I want the movement, I don't want this all at the bottom. I wanna continue it around the project. So I put a little in this section of flowers and a little bit in this section. You can see I just strung the glue. So just places that you would tuck in and fill holes. You know, this stuff is great, and I'm actually gonna put a little bit more even right here. This stuff is great to cover up any imperfection or any place you don't like. This is the time to fill that in. Sorry, I lost my thing to make sure I'm online, make sure I can see y'all. This is the time to fill in all those spots. This one got a little long and leggy. I don't like that, so I'm gonna snip it. And now that these are all glued, I can just add some in. And I really did it like this, y'all, too. It's really as simple as tucking it in. This stuff, if you tried to make it perfect, it's not going to happen, so don't make yourself crazy. Just tuck it in. Only thing you can do is keep adding more if you want. I do want a little bit of a larger piece down here. Let's see. So I'm going to make sure some is stuck there. And a little here. That's also covering up any extra overflow of glue, and I think that's good enough. So I've got a little bit everywhere. It adds a little bit more of the green, which goes with the whole garden thing. So we're good there. I don't like these messes, but I'm gonna try to live with it not being too perfect, but we're gonna wipe a little off because I'm gonna use some mediums here in a sec. So that is the first step of the details. And I see I'm running out of time, so I'm gonna hurry. Okay, so now I'm to the point where I wanted those fine details that make it look more distressed. And I said I am. I'm gonna add a couple of bows too, because I want the whole base done, because this section is just adding color and distressing and showing y'all just all the different ways that I added that. And let me put a little glue here. I'm looking at where I put the bows real quick. So this one, I still have an opening. It's the perfect place to put a bow and to fill in that little opening that doesn't want to stick, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. Excuse me, goodness. Okay, and this one over here on the little bird by the nest. Garden moss stuff sticks to everything if you touch it, because it's so light. Okay, let's put a little bow there. Okay, now we're ready for color. Okay, so you can see, I'm going to move this where you can see, because I know I'm working a little further away because of the size of this one. So it is definitely, I was okay with it, but I wanted those extra details, and that is where I don't even think we need glue anymore, so move all that out of the way. Okay, so first off, this is Glistening Waves. Actually, I lied, not first off. Here we go. We are going to use art stones. So these berries I loved, and I thought, you know, quite often I'll put beads or who knows what in my flowers and add those details. Well, I loved these berries, and I thought they're perfect with these art stones. So I decided to add some of these berries, and I like to use glossy accents for this. Again, you're going to see some movement because of drying time, but I added just some glossy accents here and there, and then just a few of the little art stones here and there. And I'm not even going to dump these for today's show, because just going to let them stick and gather wherever they want. If I get two, that's why I'm being pretty light-handed with doing that. But they will grab hold of this. This glossy accents will grab hold of them really easily. And so just add them here and there. See right there, I got a little heavy-handed. So we'll give it a little flick. So some of these will move, some of them will stick, and at the end you can grab off whatever you want. But just add these in here and there. And then we also are going to turn them blue, which is where the glistening waves comes in, and some turquoise paint. We're going to use a little bit of the brown. We're going to use a little bit of ink. Just this, that, and the other. And I'm not getting, because we're so low on time, that's all I'm going to add. If you look at the project, the pictures, and I'll put my blog up today, so you can have some close-ups of this project as well. You'll be able to see more, and that I put more. But for the interest of time, we are going to move along. All right, so now glistening waves. So first thing I did was I wanted to pull the blue through here. So this is made by Prima, it's Color Bloom. And I'm really sorry, y'all. I think that it won't be too much longer. I thought by working ahead like I did, I might make it. And so what I wanted to do was add some accents. And I did not use perfection in any way you want to look at it. I just wanted to add some blue. And this isn't dry, so you're, like I said, you're going to see some movement here. But I added a bit to pretty much most of the brown flowers. You can add some water to move it around, but I wanted this to just be, I don't want to say blended, I'm not sure the wording I'm looking for, but I wanted that continuity. Made sure I added some on the wood. So basically, it's just moving some of this blue color throughout the project. Wanted some here. The good news is about this being so big, I have not been out of camera range much. See, like right here, I didn't put any of the little arch stones. They will be there. Because even just looking at it now, I know that I want those there. So that's the thing. You just keep looking, keep adding till you're happy. And then I also want to put some on the... I know you can't see that at the top. Let me scoot it up a little. But put some on, like I said, on all aspects of the project, we're just going to give it a little bit. And since y'all saw me do it, I didn't say, but I like to just spray it on my mat, and that way I can just use it as paint as I go. As you can see, it's a soft thing. If you haven't used these before, it's a very soft finish. So let's see. Yeah, I think y'all can kind of see how that's going. Turns up a little bit darker here. And we are going to, oh, so maybe even a bit on the, like I said, every aspect. So there you go. Added that blue. And then the next thing I did was I went in with the, no, I didn't do the brown. I did this. So, because like I said, this is a very soft finish, I went in and put some of the blue, which we're going to do. This is, it's also from Prima. It's metallic rich turquoise. And this is a new jar. I put the lid on. I'll be the person that knocks it off, trust me. And then what I like to do with this is... I don't care if I've got the other blue in it, doesn't matter. But this gave me a few, and I used it mostly on the little thing, little arch stones, to give them a bit more of a dark color. Because I wanted to pull in, if you look at the berries in this package, they're white, they're light blue. I think they have silver on them. I skipped that. But I wanted to make sure that I brought in those same colors. You can also give the, you can put this anywhere, but that is where I put it. You can mist with the other spray, and then we will come back to this paint. Next thing for the finishing touches is I took an ink pad, and this is knotted wood. It's a chalk inker. And I wanted to darken these up. I didn't like that my pots didn't have much. They have dimension because they're in here, but I like the dimension of color. So I added just more of that rustic feel. More is good in this case. And you're probably going to want to take a time. Don't forget these edges here. These are going to be shown too in this project. So don't forget to add some of your blues, some of your browns, whatever you do on the project. Don't forget the edges. Remember, these are all torn. One more thing to show you is that at the end of the project, if I'm not liking it, if you missed it and you start manipulating it, it will soften this up and you can get it as rough as you want. Like I said, in the interest of time, you know, we don't have 10 minutes to spend on that. Bye, Tiffany. Okay, so I'm not going to, like I said, I'm not going to nitpick all the details today. But you can nitpick till you're happy. So that is the base. Pretty much the whole thing. The other thing is I want to show you all the words. And I will be putting a PDF on my blog. It'll be this afternoon. Maybe even this evening. But all I did was take some craft paper and I printed out, and I'll be putting, like I said, the PDF of what I used. I've already put the stuff, I'll already put the foam tape on the back, took the same knotted wood, and I edged this with the chalk edger. And we're gonna go ahead and glue it down. We're close, y'all, promise. and I actually like to place it pretty close first. The trick for me is to find those openings and make sure that it's not floating. So I know that I want grace to be about right here. So in this particular one, I like to start at this one. I started at the bottom. Let me get the glue flowing again. Two more finishing touches after we glue these down and we're good to go. And also, because these are not cut perfectly straight, don't worry about that. It doesn't matter. And then I'm offsetting them too, so you can't even really tell if I have an edge that's not straight, because trust me, I do. And I'm just making sure that nothing really lines up, but that it is going to follow my design as a rule, as a whole. Don't think water's gonna cut it. I think I need glue. I've got stuff everywhere. And this one actually is not even exactly like the first one. So, but I like it just as well with this place. I gotta get that water out of my way. It is not gonna glue anything. And I think that works. So, final steps. All right. Sponges. I used white gesso. Let me wipe up a bit of this and get rid of some stuff. I'm going to have to vacuum after this one. Okay. Used some white gesso. This is also from Prima, but as y'all know, you can find white gesso in a lot of places. And this is a very thick gesso, so I like to add a touch of water to it. You can use a paintbrush, whatever you want, just to mix it up a bit. Not worrying about it being perfect. And then I buy the large sea sponges and just cut off rough pieces, and that's what I use. So I'm just using a little piece of this. And again, this is details to me. This is making those final little things to me that make it interesting. And I think we all have kind of our own things that we like to do. And this is one of mine. And I wish I could remember who first turned me on to this idea, but from then on, it showed up everywhere. And I can already see, y'all, I used glisten, that I forgot a step. I used glistening waves to color the bird. And I think we're gonna skip that, but it's just this. And I've sprayed it and painted on to give the bird some blue. Because I'm already over on time, I'm not going to do that today. And again, this is one of those things you want to make sure that you hit the different elements of the project. You know, hit some of the flowers. Make sure you put a little bit on the wood, on the burlap. That one I got a little heavy-handed, but. And make sure you just kind of cover your ground with this, where it's not in any one place. And then, like I said, we forgot the bird. And actually, that'll take 2 seconds. So let's add some blue to the bird. Here's all I did. I just added a little bit of blue to the bird. I liked him better that way. Super easy. Like I said, that took 2 seconds, so I thought, why not? Okay, and then, last step, we are done, y'all. I'm gonna just use this lid with the paint I had. This is too long, so you're gonna wanna do some trimming. And then this, I put a little bit of water in it. And I splattered it. And if you want to know the thing that you have no control on, it would be this step. Don't even try. Don't worry about it. Just let it go where it is. And that pulled in that darker blue across the project. Gave it a little bit of rough look, but this color is gorgeous. And you can get a little closer. So like here, I wanted to make sure I got some. I don't have any right here. So if I get a little closer, I can make sure. But like I said, it's gonna splatter where it splatters, and you just have to be good with that. I know some girls, they don't like that, so they'll paint their little drops. I don't care. I'm good with it. So let's pull it up here. Let's move this aside so I don't set it in it. Okay, so let's let you see. So that is it, y'all. And if you look at it, as fast and furious as that was, where this one I had more time, they're pretty much the same. This one still is holding a lot of the blue, so a little bit more, but that is it. So, like I said, I know that I want some things, some art stones there. So you can keep on working and customizing this, and I know I'll probably revisit some details because it pulled together quickly, but that is the whole shebang. So I am sorry we went over a little bit, but I'm so thankful y'all stayed, and I hope you enjoyed the show today, and I hope to be back soon. So thank you so much for being here. Bye, y'all. Have a great day.